morning students. Next point is the active K plus ion transport. So this is another one mechanism to explain the opening and the closing of stomata. So this hypothesis has been proposed by Leavitt in 1974 to explain the opening and closing of stomata. It is also known as theory of proton transport or active K plus transport mechanism. So according to this theory, if substances are transported against concentration gradient into guard cells, energy will be required for this process. So it is termed as active process or active mechanism of closing and opening of stomata. When any process, if it is takes place against concentration gradient, then definitely energy will be required. That energy has been provided by the process of respiration. So according to this theory, if substances are transported against concentration gradient into the guard cells, energy would be required for this process. It is termed as active mechanism. Furthermore, potassium ion plays a key role in the opening and closing of stomata. So there is an importance of the potassium ion in the opening and the closing of stomata. The opening and closing of stomata depend upon the active transport of K plus ion into and out of the guard cell. So opening of stomata takes place when the potassium ions are transported actively into the guard cell. I am using the word actively. So this means energy will be required in the form of ATP, or this process is this transport is the energy driven process. So the opening of stomata takes place when the K plus ions are actively transported into the guard cell, and the closing of stomata occurs when potassium ions are transported out of the guard cell. So for the entry of potassium ion into the guard cell, they comes from neighboring epidermal cells or subsidiary cells, which act as storehouses of K plus ions for the guard cell. Now the two things, opening and closing of stomata. The first thing we are going to study here, the opening of stomata takes place when there is an active transport of K plus ion into the guard cell, and these K plus ions comes from the neighboring epidermal cells or subsidiary cell, because which act as a storehouses of K plus ions for the guard cell. Now the closing of stomata takes place upon the active transport of K plus ion out of the guard cell. When K plus ions are transported out of the guard cell, stomata get closed. So these are the two points important in the active K plus transport. The K plus ions has been transported actively into the guard cell, stomata open, and when they are transported out of the guard cell, stomata get closed. Most of the anions, these are the negatively charged ions, which balance the K plus ions, comes from organic acid, especially malic acid. So in the guard cell, malic acid get dissociated to the malate ions. These are the negatively charged ions. We said these are anions, and 2H plus ion, these are positively charged ions. We called it as cations. In the guard cell, malic acid has been dissociated into the malate ions, and 2H plus 2 hydrogen ions. Malate ions are anions, negatively charged. Hydrogen ions, these are positively charged cations. In presence of light, K plus ions enters into the guard cells from the surrounding epidermal cells or subsidiary cells, which act as the storage of K plus ion. The transport of K plus ion in guard cell is an active process in which there is a hydrogen and potassium exchange pump at the surface of plasma membrane of guard cell. So here, for the active transport of K plus ions into the guard cell, there is a hydrogen and potassium exchange pump. We know this word exchange. So, for getting something, we have to give something. So, that we call it as a exchange. So, for the entry of K plus ions, that is the potassium ions, into the guard cell, the hydrogen ions has been exit out of the guard cell. So, for the entry of potassium ion, the exit of hydrogen ion has been takes place from the guard cell, because there is a hydrogen and potassium exchange pump present at the surface of plasma membrane of guard cell. So, there is exchange between H plus ions of guard cells and K plus ions of the epidermal cell. So, this is a H plus and K plus exchange pump which exist at the surface of the plasma membrane of guard cell. So, if you see the structure of the stomata consists of guard cells and which are surrounded by the epidermal cell or the subsidiary cell. The guard cell consists of starch containing chloroplast, a lining layer of the cytoplasm and a plasma membrane. Surrounding to the guard cell are present the epidermal cells or subsidiary cells. So, these structures are important for the active transport of K plus ion into the guard cell and out of the guard cell. So, guard cells consist of chloroplast, cytoplasm and plasma membrane. Surrounded by the guard cell is the epidermal cell. So, guard cell and the epidermal cells are separated by means of a plasma membrane. The transport of K plus ion in the guard cell is an active process, and there is a hydrogen and potassium exchange pump present at the surface of the plasma membrane of guard cell. So, there is an exchange between H plus ions of the guard cells and K plus ions of the epidermal cell. These H plus ions has been formed from the malic acid, that is, it is a organic acid. The malic acid get dissociated into the malate ions and 2H plus ions. So, for the exchange of K plus ions in the guard cell, H plus ions are already present, and these H plus ions has been comes from the dissociation of malic acid. So, in this ion exchange, the anions of organic acids, especially anions of malic acid, we call it as malate ion, provide H plus ions in the exchange of K plus ions to balance the charges of K plus ions in the vacuole of the guard cell. So, when one K plus ion has been entered into the guard cell, one H plus ion has been exit out of the guard cell. So, these H plus ions has been provided by the organic acid, for example, malic acid. The formation of malic acid in the guard cells takes place by any one of the pathway. So, during daytime, the guard cell contain starch, because guard cell having starch containing chloroplast. So, during daytime, starch is converted into the malic acid. The malic acid as formed in the chloroplast is released in the presence of light from chloroplast into the cytoplasm of the guard cell. As the malic acid has been reached into the cytoplasm, it get dissociated into the malate ions and H plus ion, that we can see in the figure. In presence of light, the starch has been converted into the malic acid in the chloroplast. So, from chloroplast, malic acid enters into the cytoplasm, where it get dissociated into the malate ions and H plus ions. Now, the transport of K plus ions in the guard cell is an active process for which energy is required, and that energy has been comes from ATP produced during respiration. When K plus ions are transported in the guard cells, the stoma get opens. So, stomata close because of passive movement of K plus ions from guard cell into the neighboring epidermal cells or subsidiary cell. So, here When K plus ions are transported in the guard cell, the stomata get open. How it get open? When K plus ions enter into the guard cells, it combines with the malate ion and it form a potassium malate. Potassium malate is a compound which is osmotically active, which is soluble in water. It increases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. So, due to which guard cell draws water from the epidermal cell or the subsidiary cell, as a result of which the turgor pressure of the guard cell has been increased due to the entry of water into the guard cell. Now, the guard cell become turgid because of the entry of water into the guard cell, and it become turgid. Its outer wall is thin and elastic, it get stretched, while the inner wall is thick and non-elastic, it becomes concave, and as a result of this, stomata get open when the K plus ion has been entered into the guard cell. So, a single sentence has been given: when K plus ions are transported into the guard cell, the stoma open. How the stoma get open? As you know that the malic acid that has been formed in the chloroplast from the starch during daytime in the presence of light. The malic acid dissociate into the malate ions and H plus ions in the cytoplasm. When the K plus ion enter into the guard cell, there is an exchange of H plus ion for the K plus ions. And these H plus ions has been provided by the dissociation of malic acid. So, for the entry of one K plus ion, there is an exchange of H plus ion. One K plus ion enters into the guard cell, while one H plus ion exit out of the guard cell. These K plus ions comes from subsidiary cells, because which are the storehouses of the K plus ion. So, from subsidiary cell, K plus ions transported into the guard cell, and in the exchange of this, H plus ions are transported out of the guard cell into the epidermal cell. As K plus ions are actively transported into the guard cell, it combines with the malate ion and it forms potassium malate. Potassium malate is soluble in water, it is osmotically active, it increases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. Naturally, endoosmosis takes place in the guard cell. So, guard cell draws water from the surrounding epidermal cell or subsidiary cell, as a result of which guard cell become turgid. It increases the turgor pressure of the guard cell. Due to this, the outer wall of the guard cell get stretched, because it is thin and elastic, it gets stretched, while the inner wall is thick and non-elastic, it becomes concave, and as a result of this whole process, the stomata get open. Now, the stomata close because of the passive movement of K plus ions from guard cells into the neighboring epidermal cells or subsidiary cells during night time. So, the closing of stomata takes place when the K plus ions are passively move from guard cell into the neighboring epidermal cells or subsidiary cells. So, when the K plus ions are moved from guard cell into the neighboring epidermal cells, the osmotic pressure of the guard cell has been decreased. So, there is exoosmosis in the guard cell, and as a result of this, guard cell becomes flaccid and stomata get closed. So, for the closing of stomata, the K plus ions has been passively transported back into the epidermal cells or subsidiary cells. So, as a result of this, stomata get closed. So, this is the K plus ion transport. We say it is a K plus transport mechanism. So, this was proposed by Leavitt in 1974. This mechanism has been based on some points The opening and the closing of stomata depends on the active transport of K plus ions into and out of the guard cell. When K plus ions are actively transported into the guard cell, the stomata get open. How it get open? The K plus ions combines with the malate ions and it forms a potassium malate, which is osmotically active, get dissolved in the water. It increases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. From where these malate ions has been comes? These malate ions has been comes from the malic acid. How malic acid has been formed? The malic acid has been formed from starch during daytime. As you know that the guard cell contains starch in the chloroplast. So, during daytime in the presence of light, starch has been converted into the malic acid. Malic acid enters into the cytoplasm where it get dissociated into the malate ions and two H plus ions. So, the malic acid provides H plus ions for exchange of K plus ion that comes from the epidermal cell or subsidiary cells. So, when the K plus ion enter into the guard cell, there is an exchange of H plus ion to the epidermal cell. This K plus ions has been comes from surrounding epidermal cell because which act as a storehouse of the K plus ion. So, K plus ion enters into the guard cell from the surrounding epidermal cells or subsidiary cell, and in the exchange of this there is a transport of H plus ions out of the guard cell into the epidermal cell. As the K plus ion enter into the cytoplasm of the guard cell, it combines with the malate ion. These are already present in the cytoplasm of the guard cell, which are formed from the dissociation of the malic acid. K plus ion combines with the malate ion, it forms a potassium malate, which is osmotically active. It increases the osmotic pressure, as a result of which guard cell draws water from the epidermal cell, it become turgid and the stomata get open. Now, for the closing of stomata, the K plus ions has been passively moved from guard cell into again into the epidermal cell. So, when K plus ions are passively transported into the epidermal cell, it decreases the osmotic pressure of the guard cell. No potassium malate has been formed. So, as a result of this, osmotic pressure of the guard cell has been decreased. Exoosmosis takes place in the guard cell. Guard cells become flaccid and the stomata is closed. So, this is active K plus transport mechanism. Further, the role of CO2 concentration during K plus ion transport in guard cell has also been investigated. When CO2 concentration in the vicinity of the leaf is lower than the atmosphere during daytime, K plus ions are transported into the guard cells from epidermal cell. So, what happened during daytime? There is active photosynthesis takes place in the plant, due to which CO2 concentration in the vicinity, the meaning of the vicinity, very close of the leaf, is lower than the atmosphere. So, under such condition, K plus ions are transported into the guard cells from the epidermal cells. And as a result of this, as you know that when the K plus ions are actively transported into the guard cell, the stomata open during daytime. And when CO2 concentration is high during night time in the vicinity of the leaf, K plus ions are transported out of the guard cells into the epidermal cell. As a result of this, stomata close during night time. CO2 concentration, it is naturally high during night time because there is the process of respiration during which the CO2 has been released. And that CO2 is not utilized during night time because there is no sunlight for photosynthesis. So, the conditions are favorable for the passive transport of K plus ions out of the guard cell into the epidermal cells. When CO2 concentration is high during night time in the vicinity of the leaf, and as a result of this whole process, the stomata get closed during night time. So, this is active K plus ion transport mechanism that explain the mechanism of opening and closing of stomata. Thank you. Stay safe, stay home.